The face means a lot. It's first appearance, it's first impression. What's a girl looking for? A great smile. You pull up every dating website, I love a great smile. And I don't have that. I had a substance abuse problem, and I noticed I had a tumor in my nose. I knew it was cancer. One evening in the shower, I was blowing my nose really hard, and the tumor came out. But instead of going to the hospital, I did some drugs and I went out and shot pool and just continued my regular life. The summer of 2013, I got pulled over on the highway and I got arrested. I was transporting drugs to fulfill my addiction. I thank God for having me arrested, because now I could go to the hospital and get my cancer treated. The reason I didn't ever go prior to that was because I didn't want my family to find out I had a substance abuse problem.
When Vincent initially presented, his cancer was very extensive and required removal of a very large segment of his upper jaw, almost his entire upper jaw, and the roof of the mouth. Whenever we make a prosthesis to replace missing structures, including teeth, we need a foundation to be able to build on. And that's when we consulted with Dr. Yang and his team.
When I first met Vincent, you know, it looked like the right side of his entire face was just missing structure. His nose was completely collapsed. And to be honest, I couldn't understand a word that was coming out of his mouth, because when patients have large holes inside their upper jaw, the air escapes and they sound very nasally. And so as part of my background as a plastic surgeon and as well as a fully trained oral surgeon, you know, I'm able to kind of be able to put together those aspects of saying, what can we do to rebuild his face?
Vincent's facial reconstruction plan would happen in three stages. First, doctors would remove a segment of Vincent's fibula bone to use as a natural graft. Second, the fibula graft would be fashioned and shaped in place of Vincent's missing jawbone. Finally, a new set of denture implants would be affixed to the new jawbone, effectively restoring chewing, eating, and talking functions.
So the fibula is one of the two long bones in your leg. You have your tibia and your fibula, and the tibia is much more important. That's supporting your weight, and the fibula plays a much less important role. And for that reason, it's somewhat expendable.
So after we've had nice healing of the fibula, then we put dental implants, have nice healing of the dental implants. Those dental implants are what we use to screw on a set of structures that replicate gums and teeth. And that's what Vincent basically is using for biting and chewing and eating.
The moment the teeth went in, when I got my smile back, I cried, he cried. They had all seen me. It had been a 9-year process. And here, he puts these teeth in, into my leg, into the bone from my leg. It's like science fiction stuff. He said, after you get your teeth, we're gonna lift your nose, and it's gonna be the coup de grace.
So when someone like Vincent presents with cancer in the head and neck, the whole group sits down together and plans a course of action that not only includes the immediate treatment now, but also to look forward to what comes next.
It's unbelievable. I've got my Florida Hollywood teeth in, and my future is brighter than that. I think I may have been like the second person in the world that prayed to go to prison, because that meant I would be alive. You can pull the negative or you can pull the positive out of anything you're faced with in life, and I'm pulling only the positive out of it.